Mr. Fab back in Fab Life.
And you are fabulous.
And you are fabulous.
Thank you.
You make this show fabulous. It's people like you that make this spectacular.
Oh, thank you so much. Yes.
And at this point, I'd like to say hello to Brett. Thank you for watching our show and my beloved Eva. Hi, Eva. How are you doing? And how's Sophia Meatballs doing? That's her dog.
Oh, okay. You're making me hungry. Meatballs and spaghetti.
Hello, Sophia Meatballs. And Deborah, thank you for watching, Deborah. Yeah, we love all our fabulous televiewers.
Of course. Yeah. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in and watching us.
Yeah. So now we just saw that little video clip. Right. And Little Chucky was promoting his new album.
Absolutely. Little Chucky was one of the youngest rappers ever signed to Lil Wayne.
Yes.
And now, of course, several years later, he's coming out with his new single. It's called Bad Girl. And I got a chance to meet him actually about a year ago. And we connected and worked on some projects together. So when the song kind of was still brewing, he called me up and he's like, hey, I go by Greek G. So he's like, hey, Greek, I got something for you. I said, oh my God, send it over. So he's like, listen, you're one of the first to have the songs, you know, do what you want with it. I said, oh my God, do what I want? Okay. So, you know, we went ahead and plugged it for him on the West Coast and it's doing really good. And hopefully he'll be out here for the show that we're going to be throwing in October.
Oh, wow. That's going to be super amazing.
It is. It's exciting. So.
October is the month of my birthday, so I got to be there.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah. I hope to see you at the shows, of course.
Absolutely.
Yeah. That's good. I love October. One of my favorite months. Fall. I love November, October.
Yeah, I love that. Yeah. I love the week of Thanksgiving because that's when it gets cold.
Finally.
Finally.
We start melting. Stop melting, I should say.
After experiencing being inside the oven for
so many months.
Yeah.
And we are in an oven here at 150 degrees continuously every day.
Yeah.
Oh my God, it's horrible. Horrible.
And not even, break. No humidity.
No.
It's just bone dry heat.
Yes, like a desert. I feel like a camel in a desert. Walking around kids, you know, it's horrible.
Even some Filipinos that I met who are visiting from the Philippines.
Oh, really?
They tell me that the heat over here, it's unbelievable. Yeah. It's like I opened up an oven.
That's all it is. We moved here in 1979 from Long Beach, California.
Oh, wow.
So we've been here plenty of years, you know, and people always tell me, oh, by now you should get used to it. I'm like, how do you get used to that?
No,
if you get burned every day in the oven, how do you get used to it? It's hot, you guys.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's why, you know, we got the color going on, you know, suntan. Because really, the only activity you could do is be in a pool. That's my activity all day long. So I tell everybody, hold the phone calls, everybody. I'm in the pool. And I think once I get in, all smoke comes out because I'm so hot. Not hot looking, just hot in temperature-wise. So it's horrible.
You know. The sinners here in Las Vegas don't get burned because of the hellfire. We get burned because of the heat of the sun.
That's right. That's right. Exactly.
The sun is just right above us burning.
It is. It's so horribly hot. It's hot, you know.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
This is so exciting that event that's coming up
it's
in October.
It's very exciting, and I'm very excited to see.
And Little Chucky.
And he will hopefully be coming out as well. So we're excited, and we got, you know, big surprises at both shows. Big surprises. So.
And I noticed in the video that you had a companion in the video.
I do have a companion.
Yes.
He's my baby. I shouldn't be calling him a baby anymore. And he's 15 now.
Okay.
But he is my son, my number five son.
Uh-huh.
And I told him, you know, he was, out of all the kids, my older kids have taken different paths. Like I said, they're going to college and doing other things with their lives. He's the one that kind of gravitated towards me. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
He loves the entertainment. He loves meeting people. He's very social, very outgoing.
Yes.
So he was like, you know what, Mom? I think this is my passion. I said, okay.
Oh, this is his passion.
If this is your passion, then this is where we got to follow. So I kind of took him under my wing and And I told him, I said, you know what? I said, maybe it's kind of time for me to take a step back and put you in the front. So he's the new mini CEO of our new
band. Oh my gosh.
Yeah, Andreas.
He's considered like the mini me, the male version of you.
That's it, the male version.
Oh my gosh.
So,
watch out, world.
That's it, yeah.
Dre's coming.
And he's, you know, he really, like I said, he connects with students. You know, he's in that age group. And, you know, they pick up as far as talent. You know, some people have it, some people don't. And I think he's got it. I think he really got it. So, you know, I'm kind of grooming him. So he's my, you know, protege.
Oh, I love it.
So that's it. So, you know.
I love the word protege. Anything that is French, I love.
That's it. Oh, yes.
Yeah.
So, yeah. So we're excited, you know.
Wow.
Good things coming up.
That's super amazing. I love it. Yeah. Oh, my goodness. And I know that you told me a while ago something a little bit raunchy.
Oh, I did?
Yes.
Oh my goodness. What was it?
Tell us a little bit about that naughty little thing that you're about to open.
Venture?
Yeah, okay. Venturing.
Well, it's still preliminary, but, you know, as I said, I was the first woman to own a nightclub. Mm-hmm. And my passion, you know, when I got into it in the nightclub business, it became extraordinary. You know what I mean? Okay. I've always felt, and I know, I'm sure a lot of people probably think this about themselves, but I've always said, I feel like I'm an extraordinary person stuck in an ordinary world.
Uh-huh.
You know what I mean? I just always felt that. Not that I'm bigger than life or anything like
that. No, but you're expressive.
Very much. You know what I mean?
As an artist.
And so when I got the club and, you know, it became one of the hottest nightclubs in Las Vegas. It was downtown, located downtown, mm-hmm. where there really weren't no clubs back then. And I just got that, oh my God, it just, that nightlife is me, you know?
It just
being with the artists, being with the promoters, making sure the shows work out. I just fell in love with it. So now we are coming together. Possibly we might be opening up a strip club, Las Vegas. And it will cater to men and women.
Mm-hmm.
And it's going to be very exciting, you know, but it's still kind of under wraps. So I could just kind of tease you with it a little.
Oh my God.
But you will love it. Trust me.
It's a little bit.
A little tease. A little strip bit tease of a for you.
Provocation. Agent provocateur.
Oh, wow. Yes. There you go. So, yes. So we're excited.
Yeah.
That's our next venture that we're, you know, involved in.
Oh, my. Danger, Will Rogers.
That's right. And also, we're venturing to do an Are You It talent in Vietnam.
Oh.
So watch out for that. That's brewing as well.
I think that you should do Philippines as well.
I've been approached.
We have a lot of talent over there.
I know. That is very true.
As a matter of fact, the singing voice of Mulan and Jasmine in Aladdin is Filipino.
Really?
Lea Salonga.
Oh my God. They're very talented.
A Whole New World, the Disney cartoon version.
Wow. I've heard plenty of Filipino singers. Yeah. Very talented, extremely talented.
Yes.
And you know, the thing about it is when I've heard them, not only in their language, but in the American English language, it is unbelievable. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, I've never experienced anything like that. The transition, like, because even like Greek American artists, you'll always hear that little kind of
an accent.
Yes, the accent. But with Filipinos, I have never, I mean, it's unbelievable, you know, how they sing. It's beautiful. But I was approached, actually, to go do an Are You In the Philippines.
You
they said, there's tons of talent. And I said, you know what? We might be there, too. You might see us there, too, one day. So,
And let me tell you a little bit of Lea Salonga, the way she got her foot wet in the international arena is Alain Boublil and Cameron McIntosh, the ones who created Les Miserables, you know, the musical Broadway.
Yes.
Went to the Philippines.
Really?
To scout talent for Miss Saigon.
Oh, okay.
And that's really Lea Salonga of all the hundreds.
Thousands.
Of,
Oh my God.
Who auditioned.
That's it.
And, you know, she's had background in theater in the Philippines, which helped her a lot.
Right.
Because when she won, to cut a long story short, she went to London and her accent became British.
Oh my goodness. Wow.
And she finally made it to, you know, Miss Saigon became so huge, ended up in America, and Charlton Heston said it would be an outrage if Lea Salonga did not play Kim, because Kim was the major you know, star protagonist. Yeah.
Oh my God, wow. See?
Yes.
So you guys, you see, you get a little history and knowledge with this show.
Thank you.
That's beautiful. That's beautiful. Wow.
So up next is the final and ultimate segment of Fab Life. So don't go away.
There you go.
Yes.